So I am Cécile Marchez. I work for Nestlé as design and packaging advisor for the beverage business. So we have brands like Nescafe, Coffee Mate, and now Starbucks. And I will tell you about our journey to improve to a new dam system and how we try to better leverage our assets. So first, a little bit about me. So as design and packaging advisor, I work with agency to develop new asset, packaging, campaign, and so on. I also work with the market to help them localize this asset, make sure that they follow our global guidelines. And as part of my role, I am also the global librarian for our beverage dam portal. So what I do is I train and support users. I receive a lot of email of where can I find this asset, what are the IP rights, and so on and so forth. I help create and enrich the taxonomy, so making sure, again, that people can find the asset, and ensure that we have proper IP right documentation for all of the assets. So today I will tell you how we migrated from our previous MAM system into a new DAM, and then how we use this new DAM system to better leverage our asset and create even more, more things. So why did we decide to move to a new DAM? The first point is that we had a lot of different DAM systems being used by different markets and by different businesses. So it was very important for us to have one unique and central point where we have all the assets and everybody is connected through one system. The second reason is that this new DAM has a better improved taxonomy, better IP documentation possibility. So this makes for an improved search search among all the assets and a better relevance of the asset that you find. The last point is that this new system has, especially compared to the one that we had before, it has very improved capability to share the asset, both with individuals, so the agency that we work with, our contact in the market, but also the automated system, especially for e-content syndication. So for instance, Amazon, we can send our image directly on there from them. So that's for the why. Now, how did we do that? It was a long process. It took months. I will tell you about it from my perspective, which is from a DAM champion, but also a DAM user for my business. The first thing that we had to do was take care of the asset. We had a lot of assets that we had never really reviewed, that we had never taken the time to see what do we have in there. So the first step was to review all the assets and archive what is obsolete. To give you a really concrete example, I received an Excel sheet with thousands and thousands of lines for each asset, and we had to decide, okay, what do we keep or not? So it took a long time. Then we had to ensure that we had proper IP right information for all these assets. Maybe this was a bit on us, but we had not been very disciplined with IP right documentation. We had a lot of assets that we did not know how we could use them, if we could still use them. And the same happened for our market, for our agency. So we lost a lot of time going back to the agency, like, hey, you created this 5 years ago. Can we still use it? So this was very important for us to ensure proper IP right documentation in the new system from the start. Finally, we work on enriching the taxonomy with keywords that are relevant to the end user. Something that we realized during this process of migration, so I was representing my business and talking with the Nestlé DAM team, is that sometimes we have some differences between DAM specialists and what they think are the best keywords to use, and what our end user, which are marketing people in the market, use as keyword. For instance, We have brand for Nescafe. We have a brand called Nescafe Gold, so people will search using Nescafe Gold. But if we follow the proper DAM taxonomy, it would have been, I don't know, soluble coffee powder, something like that. So we had to make some adjustment and make sure that the end user are able to use the platform and find what they need. And the other side of this, of course, are the users. We had to ensure that all the users were trained on the new platform, that they are able to access the platform, that they know which keyword to use, what are the different filters, all these kind of things. So among our other, as I said, we have agencies. So we had to train all our agencies to use the new system. Now they are able to deliver the asset directly on the DAM, which is a real gain of time for us. And they are also more autonomous, finding assets, reusing existing assets. This is also helped a lot because we have proper IP right documentation, so they know what they can use or not. So to give you an idea of after this migration, we have archived approximately a third of all our assets. We had a very, very large amount of assets that were not relevant anymore. This was a very good exercise for us that we need to do more regularly than every 5-6 years when we change to a new system. Another thing we improved a lot was, as I said, the IP right documentation. Previously, we had approximately 20% of the asset. We had no idea what the rights were, and we lost a lot of time. And now, after the migration, we still have a few assets that don't have IP information. These are all assets that were migrated, that we needed to keep. But all the new assets that are uploaded on the new platform have IP right documentation. This is a mandatory feature of the new DAM. And now I'm happy to say that all our active users have access to the new platform. So that's great. We have our assets, we have IP rights, people have access to the platform, but still, people didn't really know what we had in there. People didn't really know how to access it, even with proper training. So what we decided to do was to reuse a lot of existing assets that were not being used a lot. And we decided to create a digital toolkit. With all the existing assets, we were able to create more than 140 assets ready to be used for e-commerce. We have created a toolkit, so it's basically a PDF where you have the strategy on how to use the asset. We show the asset, and each time you have a direct link, you click on the image, you have a direct link to DAM to find the asset easily. Because we have found that we need to help our user find and leverage the asset. So after the migration, what we are happy about is that we have no more obsolete assets, there is less clutter, we have better IP documentation management, and a more relevant taxonomy. So all of this helps our users find relevant assets for them. And we have better reporting, so we can know which assets are being used, which assets are not being used, and so on and so forth. The little challenge that we still face is that the system is not very easy to use without proper training. So for a first-time user that discovers the platform, they don't really know what to do, which keyword to use. We have a filter by asset types, things like that. They don't really know how to use it. So we are still thinking about ways to really improve the platform for the end user. Another challenge that we have with some agency is that we have been training them on the new platform. But it's always a matter of discipline and being consistent and actually using the new system. And especially for IP right documentation, this is a bit more challenging to us, and we need to be really, again, disciplined, consistent, and make sure that we do this every time for each asset. Now I will tell you how we use DAM as an enabler to better leverage our asset. So we believe that assets or every content has a life cycle. We have an internal business service that we call the Content Factory, which is in pink here. So what do we want to do with our asset? So we start with the asset creation. We put it in the DAM. Everything goes well so far. And then we have a service line to take, for instance, the artwork, the packaging artwork, create a 3D model of the packaging, which is called a CGI, a computer-generated image. And then we are able, based on one 3D model, to basically put all our different artwork on the same model and create hundreds of different variants for each country. So DAM allowed us to do this more efficiently. Another service that our Content Factory offer is that they adapt point of sale and visual asset. So again, we start with a master design, and then you can adapt it to all the different countries. You can change the language, things like that. And I will tell you a little bit more about it. They also offer service for the publishing, so publishing the asset directly from DAM to, as I was saying, e-retailer or different websites. And reporting, so what happens to this asset once they are out in the world. I will not be talking about publishing and reporting today. We will focus on the other stream. So how does this work? A centrally driven adaptation service. So as I said, you build your master design, so the perfect example of your point of sale material, of your communication poster, of anything. You put it in the DAM, and then the adaptation service, based on rules that we define with them, will adapt it for different markets. They can adapt the picture, they can adapt the pack shot, they can adapt the text, anything, and then it's uploaded back in the DAM to be reused by everyone that can find it useful. What are the advantages of that system? First, for our end user, so the market, they have one single point of contact for all the asset adaptation. They don't need to go to 3, 4, 5 different agencies for each touch point. They have one single point of contact for the same campaign, and they can do all their assets in the same stream. The other advantage is that we have bigger volume, because all our markets go to the same, again, touch point, which allows for lower costs. On the side of the asset, this allows us to have more consistency and speed in execution. Consistency was very important for us because we create great master design, and then we share them with different markets, and we didn't really have a lot of control on what happens to this asset, how they are executed. So more consistency allows us also to protect the brand image better. And finally, as I said before, the assets are directly adapted assets are directly uploaded in DAM, and they can be leveraged by everyone. So we have less market. It used to be that each market has to develop their own localized asset, and now they are able to share if they have the same language or the same needs. They can share assets together. We have used this Content Factory early this year to launch new Starbucks product. This is from a point of sale material. And we have followed a few principles for this campaign. The first thing is that we wanted to have centrally developed assets to ensure consistency with the brand guidelines. So this was a new brand for us that we welcomed in our family. So since it's new, we have less knowledge of what are the rules and limitations in terms of brand image. So it was very important for us that to be very consistent and lock a little bit the possibility so that not everyone does everything. So what we did is we decided that all the assets to be produced needed to be modular. We needed to be able to change the format easily, the product range, the messaging, everything to allow relevant asset for each different market. So we have created master design, and then we have adapted and localized based on market needs. So we haven't done everything from the start. We have done master, and then we adapt as needed. So on this note, I want to show you a few examples, and I have a little interactive activity. So I will show you different assets adapted for different markets. If you recognize the language or the country, please scream. Okay? So, the first one. Any idea? Brazil, yes. Okay, second one. Second one is from Europe, so I hope you will all scream. Netherlands, yes. And last one. Korea, yes. Okay. So, to give you a few numbers, for this campaign, we have developed 5 master CGI, so these are our 3D pack shot. Based on these 5 master, we have already done for 15 countries more than 60 different single product and more than 200 different assets that are being used on e-retailers. We had also created more than approximately 60 master of point of sale material, both online and offline, and based on that, created more than 200 assets. This gives us, so far, an average of 60% of saving on localization. So we really see a difference in creating the asset centrally and having one stream to localize rather than each different market doing their own thing. And we plan to do 35 more countries before end 2019. So again, what are the positive? What is still challenging for us? As I said before, it's good because markets have a single point of contact for all their needs. We have more consistency, more speed in execution, with lower cost, and direct upload to DAM. The challenges are not big challenges, more things to keep in mind for me, is that we need to have a more precise planning before production. So we say, okay, we want the asset to be fully adaptable. How do we build the asset to actually be adaptable? What do we need to take into account? We have also created different versions of the same asset to get ahead of the different needs. And finally, there is a little bit of additional training for the users, but for me, this is not a big challenge. It's just, okay, you need to be trained on this. It's an onboarding session, and then they have one point of contact. They can ask their question, and everything is going well so far. So what do I want you to take away from this? The first 2 points relate to the end user. And for me, this is very important because you can have a great system, you can have great assets, but if your users don't know that they exist or how to find them, they are not going to be used, and in the end, it's not very useful. So my first advice would be to ensure a proper training of all the end users, both internal to your organization and external, and also get feedback from the end user on the issue they face. What trick do they use to fix this issue? And then try to integrate them in your taxonomy or in your system. And the last point, regularly review the asset and archive what is not relevant. It's easier to do it regularly than to have to do it once, everything at the same time, every 5 years, because, yeah, when you have 1,000 assets that you have to review one by one, it takes a lot of time, it takes a lot of energy. And that's not what we want. So while preparing this presentation, I found a quote that I think applies well to DAM, which is know what you own and know why you own it. So again, it's not enough to just have great assets, but you need to know that you have them, where they have them, how can you use them, etc. So what is next for us? At the moment, we are doing a survey and interview of end users to better understand how they use the DAM and how we can improve based on their need. We are also integrating a workflow in DAM to improve the collaborative creation of assets. Basically a workflow that allows us to work with our market and with our agency all in the same system included in DAM. So thank you. That's it for me. If you have any questions.